Okay, so I want to talk to you guys about something that I feel like we do not talk frequently enough about in science and when we talk about science careers, and that is rejection. Now, rejection is maybe terrifying for a lot of people, especially those that did really well in K through 12, elementary school, middle school, high school. You're always used to doing well. And that's not everybody, but some people are used to not getting rejection. I was one of those people. I did really well in school. And then when you get into a science career, you learn, I think quite quickly, that rejection is the name of the game. Rejection is a critical part of science careers. And what do I mean by rejection? So this comes in various forms. Maybe the first would be when you're applying to graduate school, you will often get rejected. A much more common and frequent form of rejection comes from applying for funding. So applying for fellowships, scholarships, and grants, that is another source of often frequent rejection. Another source that will follow you forever if you remain a scientist or if you go down that career path is publishing. There are tons and tons of instances of rejection when you're publishing scientific articles, because scientific articles undergo what we call a peer review process, where they are reviewed not only by editors from journals, but also by peers, leaders in your particular discipline, established professionals in that discipline, and they will critique your work, and if they think it is lacking in certain ways, your paper can easily get rejected from a journal. And that doesn't necessarily mean it should have gotten rejected, but it may nonetheless get rejected. So at this stage in my career, I feel particularly compelled to share this information with people. I'm a postdoctoral research fellow, and I've seen a lot of rejection in my time. And I think, you know, if you just looked at my CV, my resume or CV, whatever you want to call it, you might think, this guy's done a lot of really cool stuff. My God, he's successful. He's a successful person. You know what? For each of those successes, there is a pile of failures. And I would argue that the pile of failures were necessary, at least in the beginning, were vital to me figuring out how to succeed. And so one of the reasons I'm sharing this with you is maybe the most insightful piece of advice I could give a scientist that's early in their career is don't fear rejection. Don't shut down as a result of rejection. But maybe another way to word that is try a lot. Try very frequently. Because for things like funding, there's a very high rejection rate that may be entirely independent of your quality as an applicant. When you submit a grant proposal, it may be awesome, and there's just not enough funding out there to fund you. So, yes, you got to grow a thick skin, but I think the most important lesson I've learned is try, and try more, and try again. And the more relentless you are, the more likely you are to succeed. And you will learn. You will learn through your failures. They are painful sometimes, but I promise you, you'll learn if you let yourself learn. Don't color it as an entirely negative experience. Color it as a learning experience, and you will succeed more frequently later. So this is a piece of advice that I have to tell myself quite regularly, but I thought I would go ahead and share it with you guys because it's one that I think stands to be repeated throughout one's scientific career. Rejection is okay. Hey guys, thanks a lot for watching. Help me demystify the world of science and the world of science careers by subscribing below and sharing this video. Be very much appreciated. Let's help inform people about what science is all about. We can do it together. Subscribe.